on for in the Navy, I hope. But before that, a word from another admirer. He's busy in the recording studio at the moment, but he laid down this track for you. Andrew, now Lord, Lloyd Webber.
Jenny, it's a great joy and a privilege to be able to be a part of this programme tonight. You have been a most extraordinary actress over the years. I think it's 7 plays in 8 years, I think, in the West End. And I suppose, more importantly, from my point of view, you've played in all 4 of the theatres on Shaftesbury Avenue that form really useful theatres. You're a fantastic actress. Without performers like you, the West End couldn't be what it is. So have a lovely night, and I'm really glad I could be a part of it.
You met Bill Kenwright in 1994 when you were in his production of Present Laughter. And, Bill, you introduced Jenny to a whole new world.
We actually produced Present Laughter in Liverpool. And Jenny and I had never really spoken all that much. And on the first night, Tom Conti said, well, you'll be back on Saturday, won't you? And Jenny said, why will you be back on Saturday? And he said, because Everton are playing Liverpool. And I heard this beautiful lady say, oh, can I come? And I thought, can I get a ticket for her? And I did, and she came, and our friendship just grew and grew, and she took on board my fanaticism for the football club. She comes with me whenever she can. She has the loudest mouth of any football supporter. Our chairman's wife is sitting over there, and poor Lady Rita Carter has to sit next to her every week, listening to what she has to say about referees. Now, I'll be accused of bringing the game into disrepute. But who's your least favourite referee?
Hang on, which one do you want to start
with? No. we'll forget that one. We'll forget. But now, you know, she's been wonderfully supportive of my insatiable love for my football club.
Well, talking of things blue, you do your bit for the other boys in blue, the old Bill. Recently, you indulged in a spot of do-it-yourself crowd control near your home. Can you bear to tell us what happened?
Well, I'm walking down the road with 4 legs down here, Kizzy, and there's a row of shops, and I see a little crowd of people, young kids, teenagers, and the window of Cullen's has been broken into, and there's a man brandishing a broom in defence and somebody else with a pole. And then they scatter, and I think I'll go over there thinking, well, I better help someone. And somebody at the bus stop, oh, there was a policeman, a plainclothes, he's gone after them. So I think, well, one man against about 10 kids, even though they're kids, they're teenagers, I better go and help him. So I did, and I ended up in a phone box, sort of apprehending 2 9-year-old girls, and basically the door of the phone box flew open and I received a knuckle sandwich on my nose. And what's really embarrassing was I didn't care about that, but all I could think of was, I'm an actress, please God they haven't broken my nose.
But it's not the first time you've been involved in this sort of thing. You obviously believe in having a go.
I get very indignant when I see bad citizenry. If people are nicking other people's things, I want to stop it and get them back. And I don't tend to think very clearly. So I do tend to chase robbers, yes.
That's how people win the Victoria Cross, you know. That's what happens.
Yeah, they're often dead. I hope I live long enough not to have to.
Right. One of the effects of the New York atrocity of last September has been a drop in tourism and consequently a fall in theatre audiences in London. You applaud the Broadway Theatre's solidarity and you're determined that the West End will show the same kind of spirit. You organise an open-air concert of carols and show songs in the heart of Covent Garden. Among those taking part were Christopher and Diana Beeney, Roger Redfern, Vince Lee, Gemma Redgrave, Paul Nicholas and Liz Robertson. Paul, it was a great success.
Indeed it was, and it was typical of Jenny to go around to every West End theatre imploring cast members to give up their Sunday to take part in this concert, and which she did. And not only did it raise a lot of money for the Red Cross and Afghanistan, but I think it also helped to publicise that the West End was open for business and was alive and kicking, and it's really down to Jenny, and she really is a good person.
It's typical of all of you to have said yes, you'd come and perform.
We can't keep off the stage, love.
Well, it's clear that you've never been afraid to take up a challenge. You've even raised cash for the Children's Society with a sponsored trek through the Channel Tunnel from Calais to Folkestone, an idea that's really caught on, I've noticed. Mostly, though,
that's
you're
funny.
Concerned with animal rights. And one of the projects that touched you most was a mission to rescue neglected tigers from, of all places, a zoo in Belgium. We take up that story now from the Big Cat Sanctuary in Kent with Will Travers.
Hi, Jenny. We're here with an old friend of yours, Ginny the Tiger. Do you remember going to Belgium all those years ago and rescuing her and her mate Bill from that absolutely appalling zoo? They'd been in there for years, but for health and safety reasons, the zoo had closed, and with your help, we managed to get her out. Sadly, Bill didn't make it, but Ginny's got new friends, like Harak here, rescued from an Italian circus with four others. Jenny, when you helped us rescue Ginny, you really helped us start our campaign against the keeping of tigers in appalling captive conditions. And I've got some special news. In a few months' time, we'll be taking them from here in Kent, which is freezing today, to a wonderful new reserve that we've created for them in southern India, the land that they should be living in. So Ginny's life is just going to get better and better, thanks to you.
Well as Ginny and Will, someone else appreciates your efforts, and that is Will's mother, founder of the Born Free Foundation and your good friend, Virginia McKenna.
We've heard what a beautiful actress you are, which I absolutely agree with. What a fun person you are. What a passionate person you are. How indignant you get. And thank God you're passionate and indignant on behalf of animals who suffer. But the other thing that also draws us together is we're both patrons of a very wonderful wildlife rescue centre in Leatherhead, Wildlife Aid, and its director, Simon Cowell's here, because you're a person, when you say yes, you mean yes. You don't qualify saying, yes, I'll say yes if I can have this, if I can do that, if you can do that for me, yes is yes. I'm so proud to have you as a friend.
Thank you.
Virginia, thank you very much. Jenny, your story has taken us around the globe tonight, from Malaysia to Hollywood, from Broadway to the West End. And our final surprise comes from the other side of the world.
Because we couldn't wait to see you again, Jenny.
From Sydney, Australia, with their mother Annabelle, your nieces Natalie, Isabella and Emily. Seagrove, this is your life.
Oh, thank you.
Next week's This Is Your Life is on Wednesday at 20 past 8. On the way tonight, family betrayal, clocking off on BBC One.